We are going to present one way to write dynamic XLOOKUP formulas based on different worksheet names. As you can see, there are several separate worksheets by individual business units, which presents budgeted revenue, EBITDA, and operating cash flow. Let's go to our worksheet summary, where we want to present budgeted monthly numbers by revenue, EBITDA, and operating cash flow by each business unit for comparative purposes. First, we want to return the January 2021 revenue number for Alpha. The syntax for the lookup array and return array in this XLOOKUP formula must be completely accurate. Otherwise, the formula won't return the correct value, or any value at all. As you can see, we apply the indirect function with double quotation, single quotation, and double quotation marks to dynamically reference the name of the worksheet Alpha in cell B5. The same process is required for the return array syntax too. If the formula is correct, you should return a value of 94 like I have here. We can now copy the formula across, ensuring the syntax continues to reference cell B4 for revenue by business unit, as well as the worksheet name in cell B5 for Alpha. The only change you will need to make is with the column range referenced in the return array syntax, which corresponds to the changing month range for the budget. Once you have updated the column range in the return array syntax, we can copy this range down the page to the other business units. To ensure our formulas are correct, we can check out a few cells across different worksheets to validate our XLOOKUP and indirect formulas are accurate. We can now repeat this exercise with the EBITDA by business unit. Again, remember the need to use double quotation, single quotation, and double quotation marks to dynamically reference the name of the worksheet alpha in cell B15. Like we raised earlier, take your time with writing out these formulas, as they need to be 100% accurate. If the formula is correct, the January 2021 EBITDA number for Alpha shall be 11.28. Just as we did with the revenue formulas in the above, you need to update the formula range lookup syntax across the time series to return the correct monthly EBITDA number. Let's validate some of these EBITDA formulas across the worksheets. We can fill these formulas down the page for each business unit's EBITDA numbers. Finally, we can use the XLOOKUP and indirect formula to look up the individual operating cash flow numbers by month for each business unit. Like the exercise for revenue and EBITDA, the column range lookup syntax must be adjusted to reference the correct month. Once this is complete, we can copy these formulas down the page to the other business units. We will do a spot check on some of these operating cash flow numbers across the source worksheets to ensure that Dynamic XLOOKUP is working correctly. Feel free to send us a comment, like this video, or subscribe to our channel.